It was legal. This is the defence that's often provided by people who've behaved in a way that most people find inappropriate. Just because it's legal doesn't make it right. Child labour is legal in many poor and developing countries. A report into tobacco farms in Malawi found 78,000 children were employed in the industry in terrible conditions. Low pay is combined with a lack of protective equipment, which leads to GTS, green tobacco poisoning. On humid days, the average worker is exposed to the equivalent of 32 cigarettes. So why is this relevant to professional ethics and specifically for accountants? Well, large multinationals have been behind the shift in production from developed countries, which have stricter laws and a safer environment, to lower cost countries that do not abide by these laws. And the accountants who helped analyse the numbers, crunch the data and make these decisions are part of the ethical issue. Just because this type of action might be legal, it doesn't make it right. Professional accountants need to be ethical as well as technically capable, and this involves doing more than just complying with the written codes and laws. There is an underlying obligation to act in the best interests of society and aim for the highest standards of behaviour. To evaluate right from wrong, which is the foundation or purpose of ethics, we need to have frameworks for determining how to decide what is correct. When professionals adopt a code of ethics or a particular way of behaving, they can build credibility and trust. Imagine a situation where accountants did not always have the right level of skill to perform a task, or do not work with enough care and diligence, and cost a client significant amounts of money, or waste their time. Accountants bear an ethical burden because the decisions we help influence are important ones that allocate resources that often have significant value. The temptation to gain wealth and to take advantage of our position may be high in certain circumstances, and we need to protect against this. For those who are at the receiving end of unethical action, the consequences can range from frustration and anger to serious financial losses or physical harm. The children in Malawi report significant physical abuse and sickness. And for accountants who are unethical, outcomes include loss of membership, fines, and potentially a prison sentence. Loss of reputation and status can also be devastating, and the guilt attached to acting unethically as a result of intimidation or familiarity can also be very harmful. Although different people may have different perspectives of what is right or wrong, accountants are expected to follow a structured and systematic approach when evaluating what to do. The top five ethical issues faced by accountants in research conducted by Leung and Cooper were attempts to evade tax by clients, proposals to manipulate financial statements, avoiding deception by presenting information properly, preventing conflicts of interest, and being instructed by a superior to act in an unethical manner. Nearly half of all accountants had experienced the top four issues listed, highlighting that this is an extremely difficult and stressful profession. You can see why we need strong ethical frameworks and foundations to survive and thrive in the accounting profession. To recap, ethics focuses on establishing a code of behaviour that is considered to be correct and helps us determine what is right or wrong when dealing with a particular issue. The impact of unethical behaviour harms both the unethical person and the stakeholders affected by the decision, and so accountants need to follow a clear set of guidelines and principles when performing their work, including acting with integrity, objectivity, and competence. Faced with pressure from our own self-interest and others who ask us to evade tax, manipulate statements, or deceive others, we must be able to stand strong and maintain both an ethical and legal stance.